Hello students, welcome to today's lecture. So in this lecture we are going to see what is the storage organization. So from the couple of unit we are actually describing what is the compile construction procedure or compile construction process in which we are going to convert the source program into the corresponding machine code. Okay, so whenever we converted the source program into the corresponding machine code or any assembly code that we want to run, till now we are not going to use any memory. We are actually going to use the secondary memory for the performing the compilation process, but now we want to run that particular machine code which is generated from that source code after the compilation process. So for that purpose we require to use the different we want to use the random access memory or actually memory. For that purpose we are going to use the operating system. So operating system will load, so loading will be happen here, will load that corresponding machine code into the particular storage area. Okay, so whenever we places that into the storage area, what will be the actual the representation of the runtime memory that we are going to describing. So how we are divided the runtime memory? So runtime memory will be divided on the basis of three parts. So we want to put the machine code, so that is converted from that particular source code. So source code converted into the machine code that we want to keep into the memory, so the operating system can be easily started to execute that. So for that purpose compiler will be demand for the block of memory for the operating system. Then this block of memory can be utilized by the compiler to executing that particular program. So that particular block of memory we call it the runtime storage, because we want to use that memory for the runtime purposes. Okay, so that runtime memory will be subdivided into this part. So one is nothing but my code area, second is nothing but my static data area, third is nothing but my stack, and fourth is nothing but my heap. Okay, so whatever the machine code, suppose here I'm defining my machine file is nothing but addition.c. So now addition.c we are converted into the addition.exe file. Now that file we want to run. So whenever I'm converted that into the this addition.exe into the machine code, we know that how much area we want. Okay, so this is a fixed size data. Okay, so this fixed size data we should keep in this particular code area. Okay, so we know that. And what is the static data area? Static data area is nothing but the we want to assigning the, because this two part code area and static area, this is nothing but my static memory we required, and the stack and heap is nothing but my runtime memory is required. So in a code area actually I'm putting my machine code that we want to execute, and static data area is nothing but this particular fixed size memory we allocated for some kind of constant or some kind of a global variables we provided this particular area. Okay, so runtime storage divided into the whole the code and data, such as the generated target code and corresponding data objects. The size of generated code is fixed. This particular size of this particular code is fixed. Hence, the target code occupies the determined area of memory. So, at the compile time, we determine how much memory is required, and according to that, we are assigning this fixed size memory here. Okay. Then, the amount of memory is required by the data object is also known as the compile time. Suppose I am defining integer a comma b comma c. So, we know that at the compile time, how much size is required for the A, how much size for the B, how much size for the C, that much of a memory we are already allocated on a, in a fixed size. Okay, so that memory is determined statically. The stack is used, and the stack and heap is actually used to manage the different kind of, so particular stack is used for the manage the active procedure. Okay, so all the activation record for the corresponding procedure or function is managed by the stack, and the heap is used for the if you want the runtime memory. Suppose in a C, whenever I'm describing any pointer integer star p and p is equal to malloc int, so we are describing that the runtime. So if I want to performing the runtime managing of a memory allocation, that may be defined by the heap. Okay, So managing of active procedure means whenever we performing the call for that particular memory, suppose there are two functions, functions A, functions B. If the main call the function A, then that much of activation record of the main will be suspended and the execution of a activation record of A will be put into the top of the stack. So all this information will be stored into the stack. Okay, so heap array is the area of the runtime storage in which the other information will be stored. Okay, so what is the activation record? So activation record is used whenever we performing or whenever we call the different kinds of a procedure or different kinds of a functions. Okay, so if you call only a main, so that much of a main, so what is the return value of a main, what is the local value or a local variable are present in a main, so what is the references to the another variable which is not declared in a main but which is useful, which is used in a main but declared in a outside of the main. All this data will be stored in that activation record. So the execution procedure is called as a activation. It's activation. Okay. So that activation record of that particular procedure will be stored into that activation record. So the an activation record contains all the necessary information required to call that particular procedure. Okay. So what are the information present in activation record that we're defining here? What is the return value of that activation record is nothing but my function. Suppose I'm writing here the procedure called void or int. I'm writing here int, and then I'm writing here add. I'm writing here add, and my passing the actual parameter like a, or I'm declaring here integer a. Suppose I'm declaring here integer a. Okay, sorry, this is not very perfect, but I'm writing that integer. So whenever I'm describing the activation record, so whenever there is a call for this particular procedure of add, so what value we record put, we are requiring return value, that is nothing but integer, actual parameter, whatever the actual parameter we are passing, that values are defining here the value of that actual parameter. Control link, so we are defining that one by one. So temporary values, the store the values that arise in the evaluation of an expression. So whenever writing C is equal to A plus B plus D plus E, so we are converted into the three address code, whatever the temporary values are created, that temporary value will be stored into the temporary values area. Local variable, so here I am declaring integer A, such kind of a data will be stored into this local, hold the data that is local to the execution. Machine status, hold the information about the status of the machine just before the function call. So whenever I am performing the function call, suppose the main will be called to the add, so before that, that machine status of the main will be stored somewhere, because whenever I am completed the task of add, we want to return back for the main procedure or for that particular call or function. So we require to keep the track about where we should return. So all this information will be stored into the machine status. Access link is nothing but whenever we want to call the non-local data, which is not present in my particular function, but which is present in another function, but we are going to use here. So all this information about the non-local data will be present in access link. Control link, that is point to the actual activation record of the caller. So main present the activation record for the this particular add function. Okay, then we are defining here the actual parameter. So whatever the actual parameters are present in that particular function, that actual parameters value will be present in this particular task. Okay, then return value used by the calling called procedure to return a value to the calling procedure. So main will call this particular add, and add will return the integer value to that particular main. So all such information will be stored there. Okay, so if I'm defining here integer main will call the function called as a factorial, the factorial will be called the factor itself, and they need to return the value. So what will be defining here? So this is my suppose the activation record. So for the each function we are creating this activation record. So this is nothing but my activation record for the each function which is present in my program will be assigning the activation record. So the activation record for the main, activation record for the factorial underscore number, so we are assigning value 3. So 3, then activation factor, activation record for the factorial number 2, activation record for the factorial number 1. So if there is a 1, the value will be returned to the here, it will be calculated, that value will be written here, that value will be calculated, that value will be returned to the main, and main will be displayed that particular value. Okay, so how it will be performing? So firstly, the main will be called. So the return value of a main, so we are provided what is the local variable, so that we are assigning what is the machine status. So currently the operating system called this particular function. Okay, then we provided there is no any access link, there is no any control link. So control link is present. What is the local variable? So look, return value we are assigning here. So we are also performing what is the local. So already we provided the local variable, then control link to the function factorial number, then we are also providing the return value. Okay, so such kind of a value will be stored here, local variable, machine status, control link, for the each and every activation record will be stored, and that value will be returned from the, so whenever we will move for the factorial number, so value will be returned to the this corresponding caller, then its corresponding caller, then its corresponding caller. So such kind of activation record will be generated for each and every function or procedure of that particular machine. Okay, so this is nothing but my activation record. Now what is the compile time layout of a data? So the layout, the amount of storage needed for the name of the all the variable which is declared in that particular program will be describing on the basis of its type. So if there is a floating point, so that much of a data we are determined, amount of storage we determine. There is an integer, if there is a character like the field of a local data is laid out as a declaration in a procedure. So we are describing that as a compile time. Okay, variable length data has been kept outside this field because this particular is for the local data and compile time layout. Variable length data, so the we can't determine this particular memory storage at the compile time. So we keep outside. So we keep the count of a memory location that have been allocated for the previous declaration. So we keep the all the count of memory location. From the count, we determine the relative address of the storage for the local with respect to some position such as the beginning of the activation record. So such kind of a value we are going to store here. Now we are moving for the another. We are defining what is the layout of the runtime memory storage. Now we are defining how we performing the actual storage allocation. So there are three different methods for the storage allocation strategy. One is nothing but static allocation. So layout of a storage of all data we already know at the compile time, that is the fixed size data, fixed size memory required, that much of a memory we are allocated for the particular code, and that will be run using the static allocation. Stack allocation, that is the runtime storage. Heap allocation allocates, so it allocate the memory, so like a malloc function, and alloc, that is in the deallocate functions. Okay, so static allocation is nothing but, so names are the bound to the storage as the program is compiled. So we are know that the what amount of memory we require for that particular variable, that much of amount we are going to calculate it or describing at the compile time. So there is no need of any runtime storage. Also this is not binding with the runtime, because the whenever procedure is activated, so the name of that particular procedure of that particular activation record is bounded to that with that static storage locations only. Okay, because there is no any runtime procedure or recursion is calling in this particular static allocation. Now we are moving for the, so we are defining that static allocation. Size of a data objects are known at compile time, no recursive procedure, no dynamic memory allocation. We know that only one copy for the each procedure activation record exists at that time only. Okay, binding do not change at the runtime. Every time a procedure called, same bindings will be occur. Now we are moving for the stack allocation. So in a stack allocation, all compilers of a language that use a procedure functions or the method that will be used, the how will be performing the calling procedure between the different kinds of a procedure, this will be describing by the runtime memory that we call the stack. Okay, so each time procedure is called, space for its local variable, whatever the data, whatever the space is required. Okay, so that will be pushed into the top of the stack, and whenever procedure terminated, the space is popped from the top of the stack. Okay, so to performing such kind of a calling procedure from the call one function call to the another function, that will be performing by the calling sequences. Procedure calls are implemented by generating what are known as the calling sequences in a target code. Okay, so the return sequence to restore the machine status of the calling procedure, so which can continue its execution. So the code is a calling sequence of the open divided into the two part. One is nothing but caller, another is nothing but caller. Caller is nothing but who call that particular procedure initiator, and call is nothing but procedure which is actually called. Okay, So this such kind of information, the activation record information will be storing whenever I'm performing the calling sequences, temporary and local data, so control link, so some kind of saved machine status. So this is nothing but my calling responsibility, this is nothing but my caller responsibility, this is nothing but my caller's activation record, this is the caller's activation record will be stored, and here this is nothing but my top of the stack point that we're describing here. Okay, so the value communicated between the caller and callee are generally placed at the beginning of the callee's activation record. Okay, so callee's activation record ke beginning mein we are going to place all this corresponding information because they are actually close to the caller activation record. Fixed length items are generally placed in the middle. Such items typically include the control link, the access link, and the machine status field. So such kind of calling sequences will be present here. Okay. In a stack allocation, the link reference is also present because we are allocated the memory, but sometimes you are not deallocated. So if you are not deallocated, so the deallocated memory is actually not used by the any another procedure, but still if I'm going to trying to allocate that particular memory, describing some kind of error, such kind of a dangling reference will be happen present there. Now we are moving for the heap allocation. Heap allocation is nothing but whenever we want to allocate the memory in a runtime, at that time we are provided for the heap allocation. So in a C, so for that purpose we are performing a pointer, and based on the pointer, whenever we are going to use the malloc and deallocate function, based on that we are performing this heap allocation. Variables local to procedure are allocated and deallocated only at a runtime. Heap allocation is used to dynamically allocate the memory to the variable and claim it back when the variables are no more required. Okay, so at that time we are powerful. Except the statically allocated memory area, both stack and heap memory can grow and shrink dynamically and unexpectedly. Okay, because it performing the runtime storage, therefore they cannot be provided the fixed amount of memory in the system. Okay, so how we are going to describing that heap allocation we are performing here. Okay, so we will stop here.